Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller from Eyes on the Sky. In this tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to zoom in and out in Stellarium. And there's actually a couple different ways to do this, some of which you may not be aware of. One of the most obvious ones is just use the wheel on your mouse. And as you click forward on the wheel, you can move in towards a particular object. And that's actually one that you probably will still use no matter what, because especially if you want to zoom in on a particular object, you have to keep zooming in using the wheel in order to get really, really, really close to it. You can also zoom out using the wheel as well. Just move the wheel in the opposite direction. But there's another way to be able to zoom into a particular area of sky, and that is using the forward slash and backslash keys on your keyboard. So for example, if we use the forward slash key, you can see how that zooms right in, and it's a 10 degree field of view. You can see that right here. That's a 10 degree field of view, so that's 10 degrees from the top all the way down to the bottom like that. And then if we hit the backslash, then it will go all the way back. Now that's really all you can do with a star. So if you do that zoom in, it's going to center it, and then you would need to use your mouse wheel to zoom in further if you wanted to. But then to get all the way back out to your full field of view, you could just use that backslash. Now what's different is if you click on a planet, let's say for Saturn, for example, notice how Saturn is not centered. But if I click on that forward slash key, it will center Saturn and bring in the entire field of the planetary system into view. Now watch what happens when I hit that forward slash one more time though. Now it zooms in on the planet and brings the planet about as close as possible. Now look at how that field of view is, you know, 0.0205 degrees. Now if we back out of there, again, just one back out on the backslash, it brings it out to the system. And then we do the full one, it goes to 70 degrees like that. Now if we click on Jupiter, we can see how that might be different. And the forward slash, you can see how that is now a 0.277 degree field of view. But then when you go in further, it's 0.05. So it's a different, depending on what the object is that you're zooming in on. So the forward slash and backslash keys are a really quick way to be able to zoom in and out of things and center them immediately, so you don't have to hit the space bar in order to actually center objects like that. And then we could just backslash like that, backslash one more time, zoom all the way out. And that's how we can move around and zoom in and out of things in Stellarium very quickly. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like being able to find more things in the night sky and make regular videos on how to find lots of deep sky objects and other things in the night sky, you can visit my YouTube channel at Eyes on the Sky or my website, eyesonthesky.com. Hope that helps, and thanks for watching.